I present to you one of the first video games I've ever owned, Pokémon Mystery Dungeon Explorers of Sky. I basically grew up with the Pokémon series, so it's not an exaggeration to say that I hold this franchise near and dear to my heart. Despite having a beautiful pixel art style, interesting mechanics, a killer soundtrack, and one of the best storylines in any Pokémon game, in my opinion, it tends to be classified as a less popular spin-off of the main game series, but I think it deserves a bit more love than that. So at this point, if you haven't already played the game yourself, you're probably saying, okay, so what's the game even about? Basically, the player becomes a Pokémon in their journey to discover who they are as well as solve the epidemic of, you know, space-time collapsing in the Pokémon world. First world problems, am I right? But there's a catch to all of this. I found a way to make this game just a little bit trickier. Yep, let's randomize it. Everything. Floor layouts, level caps, item drops, moves, even typings, all of it is now completely random. That might not sound crazy at first, but when you run into a ghost type with Wonder Guard and huge power that's 5 levels above you and you literally have no moves to even hit it, suddenly this straightforward challenge starts to feel a bit more intimidating. Combined with some outdated and inconvenient mechanics, let's see how far I can get in this randomized clusterfuck version of a video game masterpiece. Hey. Also, it would really mean a lot if you guys left a like on the video, because I did put a lot into it, you know, time and energy and silly doodling. Let me know what you want to see next in the comments, and hey, if you're doing all that, why not subscribe? It takes 2 seconds, it's totally free, and your support really means a lot. Okay, with that out of the way, let's just get right into it. So of course, before we start, I need to get my BuzzFeed government-assigned Pokémon. Everything in this game is randomized, including the personality quiz questions. So that means I will burn my bread. Do you want to turn into a marketable plushie? Fuck yeah? You find a treasure chest at the end of some deep, treacherous ruins. What do you expect to find in it? Food gummy! Alright, I am now going to determine my aura. I feel like my aura is more of like a bubblegum pink, but what do I know? Is you LGB? Cause you gum pink. A slow king? let me just see what the other options are. I could be the shiny Celebi? Nidoqueen doesn't have a gender? Huh. I kind of really like the shiny Celebi, actually. I'm not gonna lie. And everything is randomized, so this tiny little motherfucker could be, like, the bane of my existence, or God. I guess we'll go with Celebi. Yeah. Who will be my partner? A Mew! Oh my god. Oh, an Absol. Oh, Ninetales? Oh, these are such good options. I actually feel like Mew would fit the partner Pokemon really well just because of the type of character the partner is. It's kind of like this weak little whiny little baby, I say in reference to Mew. Also, it kind of matches with the Celebi too, because I'm pink. Oh my god, we're bubblegum pink! Oh my god, I was right! I was right! My aura may be blue, but you better believe our asses are bubblegum pink. It's all spooky, it's stormy. That rock looks like a Sharpedo. I feel like that's definitely not going to be significant later on in the story. Oh, my little guy is so cute! Look at the other guy! Oh, they're so cute! Praying to God, because I know I made it abundantly clear, but types are randomized, moves are randomized, literally everything is randomized, abilities are randomized, everything. We are either going to have a really easy time because one or both of us is gonna have like Wonder Guard or some shit, or this is going to be awful because we are gonna be completely useless. You know, I've always found this a little bit weird. There's a little guy in here, in the little hole, that's just looking at feet all day. You know, if that's his thing, that's his thing, but it's crazy that they just, like, bro just floated over there, and they were just like, oh, it's Mew, it's Mew. Alright, guys, anyways. Okay, so we got, is that a Poliwrath? And a Masquerain. That little wimp, that little Mew! I love this cutscene, it's so pretty. Normally there's a song that pairs with it. Oh, this is... Oh, it's gone. And it's... Alright, that's definitely much less pleasant. Oh, it's just a corpse. Look at us, we're so fucking cute. Oh my god, we're so cute! I've never seen you around before. I just flutter my wings and I just communicated that. You look like a totally normal Celebi to me. A totally normal Celebi, guys. Actually, that's funny because if you think about it, I don't look like a totally normal Celebi because this is the shiny Celebi sprite. You're a little odd. Shut the fuck. Things have grown somewhat lawless. Oh, speaking- Oh my god. Can you imagine? Can you fucking imagine being a Mew and getting your shit clapped by a fucking Masquerain? Oh, he's sad. You made him cry. I am bug normal. That is really not great. Bad dreams enables Pokemon to inflict damage on sleeping foes in the same room. Okay. Magnet pull. So... What? Fighting an electric. Natural cure isn't bad. And inner focus? Oh my god, this thing is significantly better than me. What? Oh my goodness. Okay. These are some... Holy shit. Fucking arrow blast? Wait, what are Mew's moves? Okay. Oh, look at the slowpoke. He looks so cute. Oh, bad dreams. Oh my god. Oh, that's gonna be actually really annoying. I'm gonna wake up everything that sleeps. Ugh. Magnet pull. Oh. Types are randomized. I keep... Oh, everything I thought I knew about Pokemon, my already limited knowledge is pretty much useless right now. Oh. I need to organize my... You fucking explode? Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm almost dead. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Okay, I think I'm fine. Oh, I'm not. Okay. Alright. Oh my god. Oh! That's the experience. What the fuck did I just do? Oh my god, it's psychic! It's psychic! It's psychic! Oh my god. Oh my god, no! Okay. You... have guts and type- a type-changing ability? Oh no! It's a dead end. Oh my god, are we fucked? No. No, 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 no. Whew! Okay. Oh my god, stop it right now. What's this? A dubious disc. A dubious lick. Oh my god, it has flash fire. Oh, and you have mirror move. Oh no. Okay. No, this is awesome. Okay. Oh my fucking god. Ugh. No. Third time's the charm, maybe? Did I, like, opt to play this game in extra hard mode by choosing fucking Celebi? I would. I would do that to myself. Oh, stop that. Stop! We can't find our way out of this place. Are you kidding me? We'll show you what a wimp you are. What? We'll show you what a wimp you are all over again. Holy shit. Stop, 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 stop. Oh, you have, oh my god, ominous wind. Wait, so if I hit this thing, am I just fucked then? Cause it's got mirror move on? Or can I kill it? I don't know how mirror move works. Fuck, I guess we're just going for it. Oh my god. No! Oh my god, no! Den enemy's arrow blade was my arrow blade! Oh my god, this is... Yeah, I'm just gonna keep doing my little dance. We're level 10 and you learned Tail Whip.
Tail whip!
Jesus Christ, this is the first dungeon. We haven't even gotten into the guild yet.
If you could just pass away, that would be awesome. Oh, thank God. Okay, it's dead. It's dead, it's dead, it's dead, it's dead. It's dead, and this thing is... This is... But a myriad... A what? There's definitely nothing significant about this rock that they're presenting to us in grave detail in the beginning of the game that has, like, this weird pattern on it. We've already seen from previous attempts that this combination is not great, and it really doesn't work, but I digress. First, we should go to Nidorina's place, okay, and sign up as apprentices. Why did I just throw it back on the floor? What just happened? I have to be brave. I have this little pink fleshy thing with me, and therefore God could not even stop me from stepping on the grate and talking to the foot fetish guy. See, all right, can I just take a minute? MC is on some real shit right now. Why is it that I am the only one questioning this? First of all, yes. Like, especially because we're so tiny, we could absolutely fall through these grates. Well, maybe not like fall through, but like, Our little peats are so small, they would go right through. What, does Pokemon have a problem with, like, terrorism or something? Do they have, like, domestic terrorists that walk into the building and now they feel the need to lock it up? Also, I feel like you could just have, like, a guard outside or something. Like, why do we need people, like, looking at feet? Also, why is looking at someone's feet, like, a way of determining if they're dangerous or not? Like, I'm sorry, if I have, like, a fucking 48 in my pocket and, like, Skechers Twinkle Toes on, like, do I seem dangerous? I could be wearing, like, combat boots and I'm just a good, regular, hardworking fellow. I could have a 9-to-5, a wife at home, kids. I mean, I know the Pokemon aren't wearing shoes.
Oh my God, bro.
What's wrong, Sentry? Nidorina? We have a Nidorina and a Nidorino? Oh my God. See, okay, I feel like they're married, right? Nidorina, Nidorino. Like, it just makes sense. They are husband and wife. But, like, now there's lore because the guildmaster is Nidorina, and so her husband is Nidorino. I know this because it's true, because they told me. That's cute because they're both at the guild together, but now I'm thinking, like, oh my God, her husband has a foot fetish. He's in charge of looking at the footprints. Maybe this was his idea. I don't know. All right, this entire train of thought is crashing. I am crashing the train, and it is ending now. See, and then it's like, what the fuck? They're not even sure I am a Celebi, but they're just like, yeah, you're all right, I guess. Come on in. I see a Zapdos in the corner. Holy shit. It's a Cradily, huh? Okay, it's Dillydoo. We have no time for salespeople or silly surveys. Is that why they have the locks on the doors? For, like, solicitors? Well, Jesus Christ, if they're locking the doors for solicitors? I'd hate to know what's gonna happen if they ever do have a domestic terrorism incident. What, are they gonna just pad every room? Lock the guild behind, like, 6 steel doors? Gonna be like Fort Knox, or like that place where they hide the president? Surely the steady stream of Pokemon that run away from our rigorous training proves how true that is. This is boss music. Oh my God, do I hear boss music? Guildmaster, I present to you, wait a minute. The Guildmaster is referred to as a him, and it's a Nidorina. He, him, Nidorina? Trans Nidorina? Wait, what? I have the perfect name because of our color scheme and also because of certain shades of pink. We are gonna go with Team Bubblegum. Okay, let's... I throw it back. Great, we get beds. The bare fucking minimum, Mew. I would hope we would at least get beds. We're literally basically just labor workers. Constantly. Look at the way he sleeps. Oh, I love him. What a little guy. First things first. Existential crisis. Reject existentialism. Embrace becoming a cog in the corporate wheel. Oh my god, what the actual fuck am I doing? Why did I start dancing? It's a ferret. Oh, he is mad. He is angry. Oh my god, that sprite is so fucking cute. Oh, look at me. I'm dazed and confused. And Mew is just completely unshaken by it. That's crazy because you literally did that yesterday. So I want to know how the fuck you managed to forget that in not even 24 hours. Oh my god, we're a bunch of babies. Look at all of us. There is not a single intimidating Pokemon in this bunch, except maybe. I mean, Hypno's kind of scary, I guess. And maybe Nidor, I don't know. But look at all of these are babies. We are literally a school. We are child workers, bro. What the fuck? Look at Hypno. Everybody knows what's up with Hypno. It's not a secret. He's kind of sus. He's kind of, ew. What did you just flap? Did he just wave his little, what are those? They're not petals? Like, y'all know what I'm talking about. Them fucking pink things. Ew, wait, now that I'm thinking about that might, a visual of that, and no. All right, I take it back. Oh, some of them teleported. That was cool. The guy with the foot, I'm not gonna say it. He can teleport. We're like multi-purpose mechanics almost. And eventually we're gonna be catching outlaws. So we're gonna be like the police department, the fire department, social services, I don't know. From Growly. That shouldn't have been as funny as it was. Parish Song? Of course Mew can learn Parish Song. Thank you, Mew. Give us nothing. Give us nothing. Nice. I am not dying to a Magikarp. I am not- Oh my god. That is so scary. In case you guys didn't know, if your partner Pokemon falls into that trap, you just die. Like, you lose. It's just an automatic lose. Oh! Sorry, that caught me so off guard. I just completely lost my- Okay, that's- So many things are happening at once. So many things are happening at once! Oh my- Okay. Could you fucking stop it? Oh my god. What milk is the ghastly drink? I actually don't even know if I want to know the answer to that question. Oh my god, ghastly! Oh my god. Larvitar is the chef! Chef Larvitar made us some din-din! Look at- what the fuck am I doing to my food?! Why am I- Going to bed and taking a nap and- why is there boss music? Yep, and- Spell stun seed backwards. D-E-E-S- Oh! Oh my god! These nuts! Why are we being shown the fucking wanted list with like the most sentimental, heartbreaking music? You make me like not even want to go and find them. Like, what if they have a family? What if they're trying to feed their family? I'm scared of dangerous Pokemon. If you don't shut your bitch up. Okay. Why is there just always boss music? Stupid reaches. We live in stupid reaches. This is another boy Nidorina. Another, wow. This playthrough really said trans rights. Wow, this music is so like sentimental. Just kids buying an apple. Oh, that sprite is so cute though. Look at his little face. The most whimsy, mystical, jingle tingly music I have ever heard. I just went, wee woo, wee woo, wee woo. The Grotto brothers. Are they Italian or is it just me? And now my buddy is winning the award for world's greatest gaslighter. But I guess on Team Bubblegum, we do gaslight gatekeep girl boss. It's a Hippowdon? Okay. So Hippowdon is like the third creep of the game. Oh, wow. Why is there just constantly boss music playing? Are my characters just in, like, constant anxiety mode? And just every step is a boss fight for them? Ahem, as your mentor? Ahem, actually. You know what I can't stop saying lately? I'm sure you guys are familiar with the clip of Gary opening the door with the Krabby Patties, and it's like a voiceover, and he goes, meow, fuck out the way. I cannot stop saying that, even in situations in which that reaction is not warranted at all. Like, I'll just say it to say it. It's a mess. Oh my god, he's in the walls. Hypno is in the walls. You would put the fucking creepazoid in the walls. You would let him tunnel around. That guy is a fucking menace. He is a villain. After we lol, oh, you would fucking explode, wouldn't you? Oh my god, does this have Wonder Guard? Oh no. Okay, we gotta go. Okay, we gotta go. We gotta- Oh my god. Does it have wonder- Ah! Oh my god, oh my god. Oh my god. No. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Holy shit. This is so scary. This is so scary. We need to go. We need to go now. Does that thing have Wonder Guard and Guts? That was almost so bad. Oh. Okay. Alright. Okay. Oh my god.